Hello, welcome to Back to Coding. Today we will be talking about what are the types of intents in Android, what are explicit and implicit intents in Android. This video is in continuation of the previous part, which you can find in the description below, so I highly recommend you to check it first and then come back to this video again. So far, you have seen how to create an intent that launches a specific activity using intent is equal to new intent this comma second activity dot class. There are two types of intents, explicit and implicit intents. In explicit intent, you explicitly tell Android which class you want it to run. If there's an action you want done, but you don't mind which activity does it, you create an implicit intent. You tell Android what sort of action you want it to perform, and you leave the details of which activity performs it to Android. Let's talk about them in more detail. Explicit intents. Explicit intents specify which application will satisfy the intent by supplying either the target app's package name or a fully qualified component class name. You will typically use an explicit intent to start a component in your own app because you know the class name of the activity or service you want to start. For example, you might start a new activity within your app in response to a user action or start a service to download a file in the background. In the previous video, we have seen how to create and use an explicit intent. Implicit intents. Implicit intents do not name a specific component, but instead declare a general action to perform, which allows a component from another app to handle it. For example, if you want to show the user a location on a map, you can use an implicit intent to request that another capable app show a specified location on a map. Let's create an implicit intent. You create an intent that specifies an action using the following syntax. Intent is equal to new intent in the brackets action, where action is a type of activity you want to perform. Android provides you with a number of standard actions you can use. As an example, you can use intent.actionDial to dial number, intent.actionWebSearch to perform a web search, and intent.actionSend to send a message. So if you want to create an intent that specifies you want to send a message, you use intent is equal to new intent in the brackets intent.actionSend. Adding extra information. Once you have specified the action you want to use, you can add extra information to it. We want to pass some text with the intent that will form the body of the message we are setting. To do this, you use the following lines of code. Intent.setType text/plain. Intent.putExtra intent.extraText message/text, where message/text is the text you want to send. This tells Android that you want the activity to be able to handle data with the MIME data type of text/plain, and also tells it what the text is. That's it for this video. Thank you for watching. I hope you liked it. Please do like, share and subscribe to my channel, which really motivates me to make such useful content for you. And also, don't forget to check my other videos, which can be really helpful to you, and do hit that like button.